Hey everybody, in this next video lesson, we're going to talk about the third law of thermodynamics, and we're also going to show you how to calculate the standard entropy of a reaction using the standard entropy of the reactants and the products. This will look very similar to calculating the standard enthalpy, which we learned about back in Unit 7. Now first, before we start, I want to talk a little bit about, or really review, the concept of standard state conditions and compare that to standard temperature and pressure. Now, standard temperature and pressure is only used when discussing the gas laws. Standard temperature and pressure represent 0 degrees Celsius and 1 atmosphere of pressure. Again, that's only for gas laws. Standard state conditions, if you remember, being 25 degrees Celsius and 1 atmosphere. And so 25 degrees Celsius is approximately room temperature. So when we talk about standard entropy and standard enthalpy, and even in the future, standard free energy, what we mean is that these are calculated at 25 degrees Celsius and 1 atmosphere of pressure because they are at standard state conditions. Now, the standard entropy of anything is identified by delta S with a little prime symbol up here in the upper right-hand corner. Anytime you see this prime symbol or little zero, that means it's standard state conditions. Now, the third law of thermodynamics says this: at 0 Kelvin, the standard entropy of anything is 0. What that means is that since 0 Kelvin, or absolute 0, is impossible to attain, that everything has a positive entropy. This kind of supports the second law, which says that the universe is always expanding and always tends towards more disorder. This, speaking more specifically to individual elements or molecules, means that everything has entropy. The only time entropy would be 0 is at absolute 0, and that's impossible. So that's the third law of thermodynamics. At 0 degrees Kelvin, standard entropy of anything is 0. If you remember back to Unit 7 when we were talking about enthalpy, we calculated the standard enthalpy of a reaction, basically how much energy was lost or absorbed by the chemical reaction, and we could calculate that a number of different ways, but one of the ways that we did it was taking a look at a standard enthalpy table. Now, what you're looking at now is a standard entropy table, and once again, we have elements down the left-hand side. Some of them are diatomic, some of them are molecules. You'll see that they're separated by gases, liquids, and solids. But you'll also notice that they're always a positive number. This supports the third law of thermodynamics, which says entropy is only 0 at 0 Kelvin. So these are standard entropies, which means that it's at 25 degrees Celsius, and so you'll see that they all have a positive value. Quickly, to compare that to standard enthalpies, standard enthalpy, if you remember, can equal 0 because standard enthalpy is 0 when you're looking at an element or a diatomic molecule in its most basic standard state condition. If you remember also, enthalpy is a measure of heat lost or gain when a compound is created, and these elements or diatomic molecules aren't created, they just exist. So their enthalpy is 0. But molecules could have a positive or negative enthalpy depending on if the process to create them is endothermic or exothermic. Those enthalpies can be 0, but entropies can never be 0. Now, another thing you'll notice on this table is that the solids down here at the bottom tend to be the smallest numbers. Solids are the most organized state of matter. They have the lowest entropy. The first trend I want to point out is that solids have low entropy. Liquids in the middle here have slightly higher. And the highest entropies for individual molecules or diatomic molecules are the gases. Now let's stick to just one state of matter, and I want to draw your attention down here to all the solids. Now, one thing you'll notice, that as the molar mass of the substance increases, so does the entropy. We've got lithium, sodium, and potassium here, and if you look on the periodic table, that's the alkali metals in order: lithium, sodium, potassium. And their entropies increase. So as molar mass goes up, so does an entropy when you're looking at elements in a similar group. The fourth thing is that the more atoms you have in a molecule, the higher the entropy. Take a look at water vapor and NH3. Now, both of them are gases. And so if you're looking at the state of matter, you'd say, well, it's tough to tell them apart in terms of their entropy. They both have similar molar masses. H2O is 18 grams per mole, and NH3 is about 17 grams per mole. And based on that, you would say, since the molar mass is higher, then it should have a higher entropy. But you'll see that NH3 has a slightly higher entropy, so the trend is slightly reversed. But if you look closely, H2O only consists of two bonds, with a central oxygen and a hydrogen on each side, but NH3 consists of three bonds. So if you have similar state of matter and a similar molar mass, then you look to the atoms, or the number of bonds, bonded to the central atom, and the one that has more bonds has more entropy. The trend follows pretty closely in the liquids as well. Now, we don't have liquids that are individual atoms or diatomic molecules, but water, being one of the smallest molar mass molecules listed here at 18 grams per mole, has the lowest entropy. You've got methanol, which is CH3OH, which has a higher entropy, and hexane, which is the largest of them all, molar mass-wise, and has the most number of atoms, has the highest entropy. So that follows the general trend. You increase the molar mass, you increase the entropy, assuming you're staying in the similar state of matter. Now that we know about standard entropies and what they are and the general trends with the important information, let's take that information and see if we can figure out how to calculate the standard entropy of an overall reaction. If we know the reactants and products, we can calculate this, very similar to how we calculated the standard enthalpy. Now, this information is covered in the book on page 802, but I'm going to go over it now. If you remember back in the chapter 7, or unit 7, the standard enthalpy, or the heat of a reaction, is based on the sum of the moles of the products minus the sum of the moles of the reactants. Now, this formula for standard entropy is identical, but instead of delta H, you're going to insert delta S. So for every delta H you see, put in a delta S. And this can be found on your formula sheet that you'll be given for the AP test. But the standard entropy of a reaction is calculated by taking the sum of the moles of the entropy of the products minus the sum of the moles times the entropy of the reactants. Let's do an example here. Let's say I have 2 moles of hydrogen gas and 1 mole of oxygen gas, and that's going to make 2 moles of H2O gas. Well, I want to calculate the entropy of this reaction. Well, I take the products and I use the table from up above, and I'm just going to tell you right now that it's 188.8 joules per mole Kelvin. And I'm going to multiply that times the 2 moles, and that's my only product. So I'll leave that right there. Now I'll subtract the moles of the reactants added together. So 2 moles of H2, and H2 is 130.6 joules per mole Kelvin, and 1 mole of O2, which is 205.0 joules per mole Kelvin. And I add those together on the right-hand side here. Now if I take the products and subtract the reactants, I get an entropy of reaction of negative 88.6 joules per Kelvin. Now you might be saying, wait, I thought you said entropy can't be negative. I said entropy can't be negative for individual molecules, but for a reaction, it can definitely be negative. Remember our last video lesson, we talked about the clues to suggest that entropy is either increasing or decreasing. And in this reaction, the entropy is decreasing. It's becoming more ordered. Take a look at the moles of gas on the left-hand side. You got 3 moles of gas as reactant and only 2 moles of gas as product. So you're going from more moles to less. The pressure should be decreasing, and if the pressure decreases, then you're becoming more organized. So this supports, the negative 88.6 supports the observation that the entropy is decreasing. Here's another practice problem that I'm going to show you.
So take a look at the reaction up above. It's got stoichiometric coefficients in front, and over here we've got all of our entropies for the different reactants and products. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take 2 times the standard entropy of NH3, which is my product, which is 192.5. Multiply that by 2 moles, and I get 385 joules per Kelvin. Next, I'm going to subtract the sum of my other two substances, my reactants. So I have 1 mole of N2, which is 191.5, and I'm going to add that to 3 moles of H2, which is 130.6. When I add these two up in brackets, I get 538.3 joules per Kelvin. So now I simply need to subtract these two. This is the products minus the reactants. So I'll take 385 joules per Kelvin and subtract 583.3 joules per Kelvin, and I'll get an answer of negative 198.3 joules per Kelvin, which is my standard entropy of formation. So my last and final example of this is another question, chemical reaction up above. I've got my standard entropies over here on the left-hand side, and I simply take the products minus the reactants. I have to take the sum of the products minus the sum of the reactants, factoring in their stoichiometric coefficients. So my two reactants are carbon dioxide and water. I take 12 times CO2, or 12 times 213.6, and then I take 6 times water, which is 188.8, and I get 3,696 joules per Kelvin. Now, down below, I'm going to do the same thing, but for the reactants. I'm going to do 2 times C6H6 plus 15 times 205.0. If I add these up, I get 3,420.6. Now, the last thing I need to do is take my products minus my reactants, so it's 3,696 minus 3,420.6 to get the overall entropy of my reaction as 275.4 joules per Kelvin. Now, inevitably, the question will come up, how many significant figures do I round my answer to? If I go back to my original numbers, really, this is not a multiplication problem. It's just simply an adding problem. You're adding up all of the entropies, and so all of them go out to one past the decimal. So in the end, since it's an addition problem, all my answers need to go also to one past the decimal. So this is the correct answer, 275.4, rounded to the correct number of significant place values.
That takes care of this video lesson. Thanks for listening.